NASA launched the Apollo missions in the early 1960s, marking the first human presence in a planetary body apart from the Earth. Since Apollo 17 left the Moon in 1972, no human has been to the Moon. In these long 50 years, NASA has been making plans to make another entrance on the lunar surface. Stay tuned to the end of the video to find out what they are. Welcome to our channel. In this video, we'll explain NASA's Artemis mission in full detail. NASA's plans to invade the Moon were estimated to be finalized by 2028. However, the Trump administration shook things up a little. President Trump announced that he wanted the United States to return to space in a big way. And one of the things his administration pushed for was an earlier and long-term human presence on the Moon. Therefore, NASA was given a new deadline: to be on the Moon by 2024. This rush can easily be tagged as a typical Trump move. However, when it comes to projects like space travel, deadlines have proved to be helpful. Before man's first lunar exploration, President Kennedy gave NASA until the end of the 1960s, and this political momentum contributed to the actualization of the Apollo missions. The new mission is named Artemis after Apollo's twin sister, the Greek goddess of the Moon. The Artemis space missions are focused on actualizing NASA's long-term goals, including landing the first female astronaut and the first astronaut of color on the Moon. Unlike the Apollo missions, Artemis is aimed at putting humans on the Moon for a longer duration. We're talking weeks and possibly months. One of NASA's primary objectives for this mission is research. Since Apollo 17, more about the Moon has been discovered, and the advancement of technology would enable more thorough research. Furthermore, scientists believe studying the Moon up close can help them understand the solar system's evolution. The Moon dates back about 3.5 billion years and still bears many craters and scars from that time until now. Unlike Earth, craters on the lunar surface are permanent. Therefore, in a way, the Moon holds records of events in the entire solar system, which scientists are hoping to gather and explore in these series of Artemis missions. Rock samples retrieved from the Apollo missions helped scientists confirm that, like Earth, the Moon was formed from magma. NASA claims that Artemis will be able to retrieve more samples from parts of the Moon that haven't been explored yet. Using more advanced technology, Artemis is expected to provide a more detailed explanation of the Moon's origin and the entire solar system than during the Apollo era. Another objective of the Artemis mission is to test the theory that humans can become interplanetary species. If humans are going to live outside Earth, we'd have to learn how to utilize the resources available in space, and inhabiting a planet that is just 3 days away from Earth is a good way to start. But the million-dollar question is, how are we going to get to the Moon? With the special demands of the Artemis mission, for years, NASA has been working on the development of new, multipurpose rockets and spaceships. For example, the Space Launch System, SLS, has been in the works since 2011. And upon completion, it is expected to be the largest and most powerful rocket in history. The SLS is a collection of rockets, each with a different payload capacity. Collectively, the SLS is expected to carry up to 180,000 kilograms and cost $800 million per launch. The SLS isn't the only element necessary for the commencement of the Artemis missions, but as its name implies, it'll be used to launch the other elements into space. The other three elements are the Orion spacecraft, the Lunar Gateway, and the Moon Landing Module, all of which will be attached to the SLS. The most important part of this mission is the creation of a space station, the Lunar Gateway. Unlike the International Space Station, ISS, which orbits the Earth, the Lunar Gateway would orbit the Moon and serve as a launch point for future lunar missions. Compared to the ISS, the Lunar Gateway would be smaller and more flexible, but won't be permanently occupied by astronauts. Rather, it would be a base where astronauts can research and live for a short period. Another part of the Artemis mission is the Orion spacecraft. Orion is popularly known as one of the most observable constellations in space, but according to Greek mythology, Orion was a hunting companion of Artemis. The Orion spacecraft is designed to sit on top of the SLS and will serve as crew quarters for missions beyond the ISS. It was designed with life support systems and can accommodate only 4 astronauts. In 2014, the Orion was tested without crew members on board and was expected to fly to the moon soon robotically. The final part is the moon landing module, which will be used to transport humans and their resources, including robotics and other essentials, from the lunar gateway to the surface of the moon. The landing systems of this module are designed to be used for multiple journeys through space, an improvement from the model used during Apollo, which could only facilitate one journey. For years, NASA had no design for a landing system. But in order to meet the 2024 deadline, the space agency is working with commercial companies to develop a human landing system and transport vehicles for robotics and other cargo. Some of the companies NASA has partnered with on this project include Boeing, SpaceX, and Blue Origin. Eventually, NASA has chosen SpaceX Starship to return us to the moon. The Artemis mission timeline can be summarized in 3 phases. In Artemis 1, the first phase, the SLS will take off from the Kennedy Space Center. Once in space, the Orion spacecraft will detach, travel to the moon, and orbit the lunar surface. After traveling beyond the moon, it's expected to splash down in the Pacific Ocean near California. In Artemis 1, there will be no crew members aboard, and the objective is to test the SLS and the Orion spacecraft. Artemis 2 will be the first phase of the mission with crew members. The SLS and Orion spacecraft will be launched into space with 4 crew members on board. The Orion will fly beyond the moon, but close enough for the crew members to make observations. The mission is expected to take at most 10 days, after which the Orion will return to Earth. The final phase, Artemis 3, will mark the first human presence on the moon since Apollo 17. The lunar gateway and landing modules will also be launched in this phase. Once in space, the Orion spacecraft, holding the astronauts, will dock on the lunar gateway, where the astronauts will stay for 30 days. After 30 days, the human landing system will transport only 2 astronauts to the moon's south pole, a region of the moon humans have never been to. The astronauts are projected to stay on the moon for a week, collecting samples and exploring the resources available on the moon. For example, the water ice detected in 1971. If Artemis 3 is successful, NASA plans to make lunar missions an annual occurrence and will start working on launching missions to Mars from the Moon. The Artemis missions mark a new era for space science, an era that will be highlighted by groundbreaking technology and discoveries. As NASA gradually nears the bottom of its very long to-do list, the rest of the world eagerly awaits 2025. That marks the end of this video. Drop a comment below, give us a thumbs up, and subscribe. Thank you for watching.